Lou Taylor. He's a pain in the ass that never stops moving around. Lemmy is Lemmy. He is an intelligent, scruffy, scuzzbaggish, artistic genius. Woozle drinks a lot of beer and falls over a lot and likes four-legged animals. And I am not sure what I am. One day I hope to find out.
You know, when I started Motorhead, I thought, well, nobody's going to want to hear this, but I want to do it anyway, you know. And now, 16 years later, I'm still doing it. Same horrible fucking band, you know. And people are still queuing up to see it, so it's all right. The easy way to survive is to, you don't give up, right? I mean, it's just as simple as that. I never considered giving up.
We still try to retain the same, you know, noise, if you like. We don't think about the dress much. I wear a dress sometimes. Lemmy's got a good dress. New summer frock.
Wurzel likes talking to himself a lot. Lemmy likes complaining about lack of ice and small towels. And Campbell's basically... basically Campbell.
Stage show. It's a difficult thing to say. Basically, we've got fucking nothing there.
We'll be right back.
This one is about South America. It's about when we went to Brazil, because they have an awful lot of cotton. You want to hear that? What? That's... Shoot! 1, 2, 3! Nobody want to hire me. No, I got fired from Hawkwind, you know. Actually, Hawkwind was very similar to Motorhead. If you listen, inside Hawkwind is a three-piece rock band. Right, you get all this tilly-ally and toot-toot on the top, but inside is a rock band, three-piece rock and roll band, you know. I just wanted to play, like, I wanted to be the MC5, really. That's what I wanted to be. I wanted to have a singer and two guitarists, you know, in the beginning. And then, of course, you know, the singer gave it up, you know, and one of the guitarists couldn't get along with the other one, you know. It's my solo. No, it's mine. You know, guitar players, bloody same. So I ended up, I had to do the singing, you know. Jesus. So we just ended, wound up as a three-piece. Everything in your life really is accidents, you know what I mean? The whole thing. You think about it, all the important parts of your life is an accident. Everything that you plan is shit. But the accidents is when you go up, yeah? Mm-hmm.
It's quite an honest band, you know. It never tries to be anything, flashy or special. It just sticks to one idea.
Yeah, it's gone well. It's the first time we've had a chance to make a decent album. I mean, the last album we did for the old crapola record company, they give us 10 days in a studio and told us that was it. I mean, I could have 10 days to sober up for this new record company. It was great. Mm. And there's lots of kids coming to the shows, and they're all going, Wizzo! Wizzo! We love you best! But, yeah, it's good. I'm glad. It's about time. We've had lots of bad luck with this band, and it's about time that we had some good luck.
Well, I don't take downers, but we do uppers quite often. Uppers and downers. What do you mean, in a career? Well, it's like with any band, I think. It's bound to be up and down, isn't it? Especially at night in a hotel room. It's up and down a lot of the time now.
What was the most important event in your career?
The worst down we had since I'd been in the band in like 7.5 years was the court cases, I think. You know, when we have these battles with the record company. We had to get away from them. That was the worst time for us, so we couldn't record anything new. And there's all these fans waiting for an album. Like, this album was the first studio album for 3 years, I think. So that was the worst time. But it's back up again now, you know.
Yeah.
I hope.
How would you describe our band?
Very fucking loud. And not really like any other band. I don't know, I guess it's, we're not really in any kind of a niche, you know, I mean, well, we've been put in niches or pigeonholes by the press and that, but I mean, everybody's got to be labelled, haven't they, I suppose. We've always just thought of ourselves as Motorhead music, because we're kind of, like, diverse, you know, I mean, we play some numbers that could be interpreted as, like, thrash or whatever, some numbers that could be heavy metal, and still look. A lot of it is what we would call like hard rock, you know. I mean, when we started, there was no such phrase as heavy metal or thrash or black metal or death metal.
It's not thrash, it's not speed, it's not death, crash, black, god.
Wank metal or spunk metal or whatever, you know. I mean, it was just hard rock or heavy rock, which is how I would describe it anyway.
I'm Take a traitor.